दिस इज अनदर पॉइंट चार्ज कैपिटल क्यू एंड इट इज फ्री टू मूव, फ्री टू मूव एंड द सेपरेशन बिटवीन देम इज आर, मास ऑफ द चार्ज इज एम. ओके सो फाइंड इफ फ्री चार्ज इफ इज रिलीज्ड फ्रॉम रेस्ट फाइंड इट्स स्पीड व्हेन इट रीचेस इंफिनिटी. ओके सो यू नीड टू फाइंड दैट. साक्षी सिंह 2 KQ² अपॉन एम आर रूट ऑफ दैट. डेविस इज सेइंग 2 KQ² अपॉन रूट आर. हैव वी डन दिस टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चंस अर्लियर? इट अपीयर्स दैट यू आर एन एक्सपर्ट. ओके एवरीवन प्लीज पे अटेंशन. सो व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू डू हियर इज वी आर गोइंग टू अप्लाई एमईसी. सो by mechanical energy conservation. What mechanical energy conservation says, PE initial plus KE initial of system is equal to PE final plus KE final of system. So basically, total mechanical energy before and after remains constant or conserved or unchanged. So how much is PE initial at the beginning? So that is K into Q1 into Q2 upon R. Plus kinetic energy initial, that is zero. Why? Because the charged particles are at rest. So if particles are at rest, the kinetic energy will be zero. PE final. Now the charges have reached at infinite distance. So one charged particle is not able to apply any force on another charged particle. Why? Because they are at infinite distance. So when there is no interaction between the two charges, their potential energies will be zero because they are at infinite distance. plus ke final. So there is only one particle which is moving. So that will be half m into v final square. So from here, what we can see is v final square is equal to 2kq square by mr. And that gives you v final is equal to under the root of 2kq square by mr. That is the answer. That is the answer which we are getting today. Please note everyone and understand, because you will be getting many noted.
Yes, sir.
All right. Next question. I hope you all have noted this. Next question. This time we have 2 point charges QQ. Their masses are MM. And the separation between them is R initially. So if charges are released from rest, and this time both are free to move. If two point charges QM each are free to move, find their speeds when separation between them becomes infinite. Okay. Yash Gaurav is saying, sir, can you, he has deleted something. Yash Gaurav has posted something and now he's, whatever you are saying, yes, it will be done 100%. Okay. We are doing everything for you only. All right. So whatever you are saying, whatever it was, it will be done. Okay. A pura school, institute, everything is for you only. Yes. All right. Oh, you were asking for a doubt discussion class. Definitely it will be done. Okay. Don't worry, it will be done. When do you want that discussion class? Tell me. Yes. Okay. So in this question, both the charges are free to move. In this question, both the charges are free to move. So again, we are going to solve through MEC. So by mechanical energy conservation, so PE initial plus KE initial, that means total mechanical energy initially must be equal to total mechanical energy finally. So PE initial plus KE initial is equal to PE final plus KE final. All right. How much is PE initial? So that is KQ square by R. And how much is KE initial? That is zero. How much is PE final? So that will be, they are now at infinite distance, mind it. So that will be zero. KE final. So this time we have half M V1 square plus half M V2 square. But as both the charges have equal mass, as masses of each charge is equal, V1 is equal to V2 is equal to V final. Okay, so what we can do, KQ square by R is equal to 2 times 1 by 2 MV final square, right? And from here, what you can see is V final is equal to KQ square upon MR. Answer. So V final is equal to KQ square upon MR. Noted, everyone. Any doubt, any questions?
Yes.
Any doubt, any question by anyone?
Yes.
Do not hesitate. Feel free to ask. Do not hesitate. Feel free to ask. All right. Next question. So this is Q. This is Q, this is M1, this is M2, and this is R. Okay, so if two charges are free to move, if two charges are free to move, if two charges are free to move, find their speed. Find their speeds when separation between them becomes infinity. And separation between them becomes infinity. Please find. Samarth, please keep yourself on mute. Thank you, Samarth. Aradhya Singh, V1 is equal to root of 2kq square upon r m2 v2 by m1 with a minus sign in between. What is the value of v2, Aradhya? Because you need to find V2 also. You need to find V1 as well as V2.
I was typing the
answer. Okay, please type, continue. Sorry for the disturbance. Very nice. Everyone, please pay attention to the answers written. V1 is equal to root of 2 kq square by r minus m2 v2 by m1. Okay. And how much is V2? V2 is root of 2 kq square by r minus m1 v1 upon m2. So let me tell you a story. There were two persons. Okay. मैंने पूछा आराध्य से कि आराध्य राम का घर कहाँ पे है. सो आराध्य बोलता था श्याम के घर के सामने. आई सेड ओके. फिर मैंने पूछा श्याम का घर कहाँ है, तो बोलता है राम के घर के सामने. फिर मैंने पूछा दोनों का घर कहाँ है, तो बोलता है आमने सामने. आर यू गेटिंग इट? सो V1 इज डिपेंडेंट ऑन V2 एज पर हिज आंसर, एंड V2 इज डिपेंडेंट ऑन V1, एंड वी डोंट इवन नो द वैल्यू ऑफ V1 एंड V2. So what you have done, Mr. Aradhya? What you have done? Do you realize that? Are you yes. realizing what you have done? Can you reach to anyone's place now, Ram or Shyam?
No.
With these calculations, you cannot reach. With these calculations, you cannot reach. And always remember, you cannot give variable answer. You cannot give variable answer. All right? Your answer always should be in terms of variables which are given in the question. You cannot create new variables while writing the answer. Okay? V1 and V2 are the variables. If variables are present in your answer, then it is not answer. It is stupidity. All right.
Yes.
Then attempt further. Sakshi is saying V1 is equal to root of 2 kq square upon into m2 upon r m1 m2 plus m1 square. I don't know whether it is right or not, but she has not used variables, so that is okay. Correctness of answer, I cannot tell as of now. I have to solve it to tell you the answers. All right, enough time given. Let us solve. Basically, as we have done previous questions using MEC, we need to do something like that here also. So by MEC, mechanical energy conservation. And first part will be same, left hand side will be same, and that will be PE initial plus KE initial is equal to PE final plus KE final. PE initial, KQ square by R plus K initial zero, because initially the charge particles are at rest. Now PE final, they have gone to infinity, so that will be zero plus KE final. That will be half M1 V1 square plus half M2 V2 square, because this time masses are different. So V1 and V2 will be definitely different. So this is equation number one, and we have two variables, V1 and V2. So what we can do, either we can play like Aradhya has done, or we need to get one more equation. Always remember, the number of variables you have, same number of equations are required to solve. Okay, if your number of equations are lesser than the variable, you won't be able to solve. Nobody can solve in that case. Okay, so we need one more equation. So which way we can create the equation? Pay attention. So by linear momentum conservation, LMC, by linear momentum conservation. So M1 V1, or you can say M1 U1, M1 U1 vector plus M2 U2 vector is equal to M1 V1 vector plus M2 V2 vector. This is your general equation of linear momentum conservation, general equation. M1 U1 is 0, M2 U2 is 0, because both charges are at rest. Now M1 V1. So M1 into V1, I'm considering V1 is going towards right. V1 will be towards left, it's okay. So M1 V1 minus M2 V2, because this time direction of motion is reversed for V2 as compared to V1. So from here what you get is V1 is equal to M2 V2 upon M1. V1 is equal to M2 V2 upon M1, and let us put that in equation 1. So by putting this in equation 1, what we can see, KQ square by R is equal to half, and I'm putting value of M1 now, V1 basically. So that will be M2 V2 square upon M1. Square plus half M2 V2 square, right? So this half goes this side. I am going to do the calculation in a quick way. So what do we get is basically V2 square in the bracket, we have M1 M2 square, M1 M2 square upon, no, not M1, M2 square upon M1 plus M2 is equal to 2 times KQ square by R. Okay. So let me take LCM also. So V2 comes out to be 2M1 KQ square by R upon We have a musical person in our class, music lover, along with singing. Very nice. So who was the singer? So 2m1 kq square upon m2 square plus m1 m2 and bracket of that. This is the value of V2. This is the value of V2. How many of you got this value of V2? Please note it and understand it. Noted, everyone. Now, using the same way, similarly, you can is equal to root of 2m2kq square upon r. I am simply using the symmetry principle. So this time, rather than m2 square, it will be m1 square plus m1. Okay. I wrote this answer just by using symmetry. Very nice, Aratya. Very nice. No, you missed m1 m2 in the numerator. You missed m2 in the numerator, Aratya. You missed it. You missed it. I hope you all have understood how we have done this. Let me give you another question of, all right, it's fine. I'm giving you another question of similar type. Okay. Question. This is Q, this is Q, this is R. This is M1 and this is M2. If M1 and M2 are released from rest, if M1 and M2 are released from rest, find speed of each charge. Find speed of each charge when separation between them. When separation between them becomes 2R. When separation between them becomes 2R. Please find everyone. This time I am expecting you to solve this quickly. I am expecting you to solve this quickly.
Yeah, that's what I'm going to be, or people think I'm for, but no, I don't know.
Please give answers quickly. Amol is saying root of kq square into m2 upon r m1 m2 plus m1. Amol, slightly you need to check your answer is not dimensionally correct. Amol, there need to be a slight change. You are adding m1 with m1 into m2. On one side dimension is m to the power 1. And on another side m1 m2 dimension is m square. How you can add m square with m to the power 1? Okay, you have made dimensional mistake. If you look smartly, okay, and carefully, then you will realize that there is not much difference between this question and the question which we have just solved. Let me show you how. So by MEC, so what MEC says, K, let me write it properly, PE initial plus KE initial. PE initial plus KE initial is equal to PE final plus KE final. Okay. PE initial is KQ square by R plus 0. Now this time PE final won't be 0. Yes, Aditya, you are right. You have looked it smartly. So it will be KQ square by 2R plus half M1 V1 square plus half m2 v2 square. Okay, so basically what will happen in next step is kq square by 2r is equal to half m1 v1 square plus half m2 v2 square. This is equation number one. Now by LMC, I am writing directly this time, 0 plus 0 is equal to m1 V1 minus M2 V2. So basically the only thing that is changed is this expression, and which has become now KQ square by 2R. Earlier it was only KQ square by R. So our answers will be, I'm writing answers directly. So V1 will be KQ square M2 upon R M1 M2 plus M1 square. Okay. And root of that. Similar. Okay. So that will be KQ square into M1 upon R, and that will be M1 M2 plus M2 square. Okay, that's the answer. All right. Understood? Let us move further. Question. these are two blocks of mass m each. This is a spring of spring constant. The ground is smooth. And charge on this is Q, this is Q. So if the natural length, of spring is L naught, and
so the spring
masses are released from rest, find maximum elongation in spring after masses are released. Please find.
The screen's full. Yes, sir.
What to do? Please wait. I hope it will appear after some time. I am doing my best, you give your best. Okay. Is it visible now? Okay, everyone, please pay attention. So initially, the situation is like this. After some time, these will be repelled due to charge, and this distance is L naught, and final distance, let's say, become L. Okay. So, by MEC, PE initial plus KE initial is equal to PE final plus KE final. So how much is PE initial? So initially, if you see, the charges are at of distance L naught. So KQ square upon L naught. This is potential energy of charges due to electrostatic. Plus KE final zero, PE final. Now when the charges are moving away from each other, so final distance becomes KQ square by L, right? So this will be the energy of electrostatic plus half K X square. That will be the energy stored in spring. Okay. And plus zero, because kinetic energy in that case will also be zero. Charges will be at rest when the elongation is maximum or spring is maximum stretched. So from here, what you can observe is half kx square is equal to kq square 1 upon L naught minus 1 by L. Okay. And remember, this value of k and this k is different. So let me write it as k dash, because one is k for spring. One is spring and one is k for electrostatic. So these two k's are different. The values of k are different. All right. So, yeah, what we are doing now is x square is equal to kq square, and 2 also comes here, upon k dash. And now you can write it as L minus L naught upon L naught. So X will be under the root of this. Answer. This should be the answer. If you have any doubts, please do not hesitate and discuss. Sakshi, if you have any doubt, do not hesitate and discuss. Amod is saying, sir, why x is not equal to L? Chotu, x is basically, if you want to talk in that terms, x is nothing but L minus L naught, because initially spring had natural length L naught. Okay? Initial length of spring was not zero, Amod. X, L and L naught are related by this connection. X is equal to L minus L naught. X is equal to L minus L naught. Understood now, Amod? Understood now, Amod? Yash is saying, sir, could you explain again, please? Yes, yes, of course. So in this question, what we did basically, we applied mechanical energy conservation. All right. Now, what mechanical energy conservation says? Initial potential energy plus initial kinetic energy must be equal to final potential energy and final kinetic energy in the absence of non-conservative forces. So here, the surface is smooth. So if surface is smooth, that means friction. So we can ignore friction and we can simply apply MEC. So how much is initial potential energy? It is KQ square by L naught, right? How much is initial kinetic energy? Both the blocks are at rest initially, so it is zero. P final potential energy. So now when the spring is elongated, there will be two type of final energies. One is final energy of charges with each other. So that will be electrostatic energy. So that, how much is that? KQ square by L. And there will be final potential energy stored in spring also. And that will be half into K dash into X square. Here K dash is the spring constant. K dash is the spring constant. And when we solved it down, we got X is equal to root of 2 KQ square upon K dash into L minus L naught upon L L naught. Okay. Yes, Gurav, now you understood? Yes, Gurav, understood? Say yes, sir. Very nice. Next question. So there is a smooth ground and this is wall. This is wall. And then there is a spring of spring constant K dash. The charge on this, or you can say surface charge density on the wall, is sigma, non-conducting. Okay. And there is a charge, or you can say block, having charge Q naught. So this is charge Q naught. And this is going with velocity V naught. Question says, find maximum compression in spring. Find maximum compression in spring. Initially, spring in its natural length. Initially, spring is in its natural length. Okay, please find.
What happened?
Sakshi Singh, sir, in the previous question, I was the variable which was not given in the question, but it was there in the final answer. Just a second. This and this both were given, Sakshi. L was given. See the diagram. Or if you are saying, no, even if suppose you are saying that, sir, L was not given, all right, what you can do, you can get this L and X interrelated, and then you can eliminate. Okay. Basically, that can be, what is L? L can be written as L naught plus X. Then you have to solve further. You can do even that also. Okay. Even if you L was not given, though it was given, but even with that, what you can do, you can write L is equal to L naught plus X, and then the whole thing will be in X only, and L will be eliminated. Okay. So both ways you can solve it. It's up to you. Now in this question, Yash Kamath is saying that X is equal to MV naught square upon K plus 2KQ sigma into pata nahi kya likha hai, but bahut kuch likha hai. Everyone, please pay attention. Please pay attention in this question. So again, the thing is, we are going to apply this time work energy theorem. By work energy theorem. What is work energy theorem? Basically, it is advanced version of mechanical energy conservation. At such places where mechanical energy conservation doesn't work, work energy theorem works. And what is work energy theorem? It says that W all is equal to delta K. What is W all? W all means work done by all the forces. Work done by all the forces will be work done by gravity plus work done by normal reaction plus work done by spring plus work done by electrical force is equal to delta K. Change in kinetic energy. Now pay attention, work done by gravity is zero because gravity is acting vertically downward and displacement is along horizontal. Similarly, work done by normal reaction will be zero because normal reaction is acting vertically upward and displacement is in horizontal direction. So only forces which are going to do proper work will be work done by spring, work done by. So how much is work done by spring? So if you pay attention, displacement is towards wall and spring force is away from the wall. So work done by spring will be negative and it will be minus half k dash into x max square. Okay, this is work done by spring. Now how much is work done by electrostatic force? So electrostatic force will be sigma upon 2 epsilon naught, this is electric field, into q naught, so that becomes force. And suppose displacement is x, so force is in opposite direction, displacement is in opposite, so work done by electrostatic force will be minus q sigma upon 2 epsilon naught into x max. All right, any doubt in this up to this, anyone? Any doubt up to this? Because after that nothing is left in this question and question is very easy now. So work done by spring is half into k dash into x square max minus q sigma upon 2 epsilon naught into x max is equal to, now ke final is zero and ke initial was half mv naught square, so minus 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 will get cancelled at all three places, minus and minus, and by 2 here, by 2 here, by 2 here. Basically we have now quadratic, and quadratic says k dash into x max square plus q sigma upon epsilon naught into x max minus m v naught square is equal to zero. Now can you solve this quadratic and get the value of x? Can everyone solve this quadratic and get the value of x? Please quickly solve it and give me the answer. Okay. Please quickly solve this and give me the value of x max. Please do that. Please do that. Aditya saying, sir, why do we have minus sign? Aditya, work done is calculated as Fs cos theta. Force into displacement into cos theta. Here theta is angle between force and displacement. In our cases, angle theta is 180 degree. Cos 180 is minus 1. So that's why we have minus sign. Okay, Aditya. Okay, Aditya. All right. Yash Kamath is saying, sir, could you please explain how do we got work done by electric force? Aditya, work done by electric force is nothing but force into displacement. Now, how much is force? Force is electric field into charge. Electric field is sigma upon 2 epsilon naught. I hope you still remember that. So, sigma upon 2 epsilon naught is electric field into Q. So, Q sigma upon 2 epsilon naught becomes Q sigma upon 2 epsilon naught becomes the force. How much is displacement? It is X max. So, force into displacement into cos 180 becomes the work done. Understood, Yash? Yash, have you understood? Okay, all right. So that is how we solve such type of questions. Good. So in the next class, we'll be studying many more such questions and other topics. You keep solving questions in the meantime. And very soon we are going to keep a discussion session as instructed by Yash Gurav. All right. So keep solving questions, keep studying. See you in the next class. Bye-bye.